ago because we're doing this.
Tell me about the good old days.
So this is John, and this is his brother Paul, and the date is March 1st, 2008, and we're going to do some videotaping to
take me back,
learn a little bit about these guys' lives and their parents' lives. This is their story. We're going to ask questions. If you don't want the answer, you can ring the bell. So first of all, John, what is your full name?
John Charles Svensson.
You know, it was interesting. When I first met you two, I knew he was Paul John. I thought you were John Paul.
Well, that's what everybody used to think when we were kids. How come you're not?
I don't know why. I don't know where I got that.
And where did Charles come from?
Yeah, where did Charles come from?
That must have been an old boyfriend of my mother's or something.
What's your current address?
2534 Bradford in Hayward.
And how long have you lived there?
49 and a half years.
Wow. When, where, and in what town were you born?
Oakland, California, May 27th, 1933.
Do you remember anything about your birth?
Yeah, I remember waking up and looking all around.
I remember one thing about your birth. Your mother never paid the doctor.
Yeah, I know that. She said that my father should have been that went to pay, and I guess he never paid it, so nobody ever paid it. So that, I always did. I was born free.
Yeah. And that, is there any other story about your birth that you should tell your family?
No, not really, except that my mother and father split when I was about 6 months old, and that's that was all that we knew of my father. After that, he went other ways, you know.
Do you know where, when, and where your father was born?
We thought he was born in Oakland, but he was a local guy, and he spent his whole life in the Bay Area. He lived in San Francisco, you know, quite a while, but we didn't have any contact with him.
You don't know much about him as a young person?
Except that he was an excellent piano player. He was a concert pianist, he used to say.
How many sisters and brothers were in his family?
He had two sisters. One died at the age of, what, do you remember?
No, I don't.
Elsa said during one of those flu epidemics in the early 1900s, and she was like 18 months old or something.
Yeah, I
might have it written down someplace. So the one sister that survived, her name?
Elsa.
What was her whole name?
Elsa, I don't remember.
Josephine? Was it Josephine?
Josephine, yes. And she lived well into her 80s, never got married.
About your mother, when and where was your mother born?
She was born in New York State, in Oswego, New York, in 1904, I believe.
Right.
And do you know anything about her family and childhood?
She had a brother and sister, and the family was... Family life was not too great, I guess. Her mother and father seemed to fight all the time, she used to tell us, and they weren't happy. And but, you know, they got through it, all right.
Were you raised by both your mother and your father? And if not, with whom did you live and why?
Oh, well, my mother raised me and Paul, you know, from early on, from when I was 6 months old, and I would be staying with different people from time to time when my mother was working, but my mother raised us.
And so, where are you in the sibling line?
Oh, I'm the second child of two boys, Paul and I.
Has your relationship with your brother changed over the years?
Oh yeah, I think we've gotten a lot closer. When we were kids, we didn't fight, but we weren't real buddies. We had our separate friends. I think Paul and I have gotten to be really, really good friends. I think we have more in common now than we did when we were kids. I don't know why that would be, but we seem to.
What did your mother teach you that helped you succeed in life?
That helped me what?
Succeed in life.
I don't know if I've succeeded in life, but but she, I think honesty is the thing that I would point to her for. I mean, she believed in being absolutely honest and to not tell a lie, and I don't know of any lie she's ever told. And I remember one time when I broke a window and I tried to get out of it and say that I didn't do it. And somehow they pinned it on me. And she didn't yell and scream, but she sat me down. I don't know, maybe I was 8 or 9 or so. And she sat me down and said, "How would you like it if I lied to you all the time?" And she gave me a couple examples. And would you like it if I was telling you like, and I'm really, it made an impression on me in my whole life. It's honesty.
You feel that too?
Yeah, I think that's pretty true.
That's what I remember. Yeah, I remember her always talking about honesty.
Yeah.
Was the, and what about Santa Claus? You guys didn't even know, she didn't tell you about Santa Claus, did she?
We didn't know there was such a person as Santa Claus. And I, I don't believe our friends had a whole lot of, did our friends think that Santa Claus gave them their presents? I don't
remember it really.
Maybe it wasn't a big thing. I was going to say something else about what mother, she had a thing for language too. She couldn't, couldn't accept if we kids spoke ungrammatically or just used, I was always glad for that. We would have a test in school, where he ain't going to do this or he isn't going to do, and some of the questions I thought any idiot ought to be able to answer that, but of course I knew it because my mother corrected us. Anything we said that was not exactly correct, she would correct us.
She loved her crossword puzzles.
Yeah.
And about your grandparents, when and where were your mother's parents born?
My mother's father came from Boston, and I have no other information about him because I never knew him. And my mother's mother would have been born in Oswego, New York, too. And of course, I knew her when they all migrated to California.
What have you been told about those grandparents' lives when you were young? Did you have any stories from your grandparents about their young lives, how they lived their life?
I think it was a pretty simple life in a small town. I think my grandmother was from a family that was maybe not wealthy, but they were they didn't hurt for money.
He had a pretty good job, really.
Yeah,
he was a salesman for what was it? Meat company that he worked for.
Yeah, Armour and
Company. Armour, that's it.
Now you're talking about her father. I'm talking about the grandparents, your mother's mother.
My grandmother, right? Yeah.
Oh yeah. Okay. I was thinking about your grandmother's parents.
Grandmother's parents. We don't.
We don't know.
Yeah. Well, you know that she was one of five boys,
oh, yeah.
right?
One five boys.
Well, we know somewhat, but not that much.
Yeah.
I mean,
and we do have some photographs of those people.
Yeah, there was.
And they had servants.
Yeah, they were pretty.
Yeah, I think you said that. Yeah, where were you talking about your mother's parents or your mother's grandparents?
Well,
when you said they were wealthy, because they had a nice big house. That's the Whites.
Whites, yeah.
Yeah.
He had one of the brothers had a knitting mill, and he invented the herringbone weave.
Yeah.
And so they, you know, they were pretty well off. And they were big lawyers, and a lot of the kids did pretty well.
Did your mother, Florence, have any kind of a special story she liked to tell about her mother? As her mother, Jessie, as a child or as a young adult? She married awfully young.
Yeah,
Jessie
she
did.
Really young, and I what I remember my mother talking about her mother was this same thing about this honesty thing, you have to be straight with people. I'm thinking of the time when my mother said that she. Maybe you can help me remember. She offended somebody, and she had a fight with one of her friends. I guess that's what it was. And my mother's mother marched.
So you're saying Florence had a fight?
Yeah. Jessie, my grandmother, marched her over to the house of the people that were where the girl lived, who was somehow they had gotten in a fight, and was to force my mother into saying she was sorry. Well, she sat there all day, she said, and into the dinner hour, and would not say she was sorry. But I know, gee, how my mind slipped. I don't remember how it ended, but I know she eventually just said, I'm sorry, or something like that. Mm-hmm. Do you remember that story?
Yeah. Well, she had a history of being feisty as a child.
Florence
did, and because her brother had mental deficiencies, kids picked on him, and she always defended him, and she got in fights over that. Maybe that's
She couldn't stand to see the kids picking on Tommy.
Right.
And this kid, Tommy. Evidently, it was a really hard birth, and in those days, the baby wouldn't come out. They didn't do a cesarean. They reached in to the baby's head and grabbed a hold of the head with forceps and pulled the baby out. And his hearing was severely impaired, and that's what made people think he was not very smart. However, he did go to college and he graduated from college. And I couldn't, it just was unfortunate.
But he ended up in the institution, that's the thing. Makes you wonder about the whole situation.
You wonder if today, with today's advances, it might have been a whole different story.
That's true.
What memories do you have of your grandparents when you're growing up?
Oh, our family was very close. There were not many of us, and growing up we had my mother and her mother and my Aunt Marion, that would be my, my mother's sister, and Marion's daughter, and that part of the family, that was it with Paul and I and mother, and we'd have celebrations at Thanksgiving and Christmas and so on, and we were very compatible, and I think we were close. Then there was also my father's side, and we would go visit them, but they never commingled as a group ever that I know of. My father's parents and didn't, hobnob with my mother's. And if As for the others, there was my father's mother and father
and their names,
sister, Fred and Mary, and Elsa, the surviving of the two sisters. One of them, we said, already died young. So.
And where did they live?
They lived in, on 14th Street in Oakland for years. And I can remember that house. Paul can probably remember it better, but they moved in 1939 out to San Leandro and lived there, you know, until the end of their lives, all of them.
Now, the house in Oakland, is that still there?
I don't think it's there now. I think it's been torn down.
That shredded wheat plant was right across the street from. Is that still there? I'm not sure about that.
The plant itself, maybe. I don't think it's a shredded wheat anymore. But it was on 14th Street, near where what now is Cypress Street. But that when they moved there, it was probably a nice part of town. But they just felt it was deteriorating, and they wanted to move to San Leandro, which at the time was like, you know, moving to Timbuktu because it was just really far.
Do you remember what they paid for that house in San Leandro?
I don't remember, but
I think it was something like.
I think it was $3,900.
No, it's a little more.
No, because I think we have the paperwork, and Elsa said they for $100 more, they added the laundry room.
Well, I could.